myself finessing. Straight up, I can't go one day without finessing. Finessing.
I came up 100 minutes, we straight off finessing.
Straight up, finessing.
What's good, YouTube? This your boy, Jay Dickey 92, coming at y'all with a custom. So before I get into that, just because it's a custom, go ahead and hit that thumbs up, that like button, subscribe, share with all your friends and everything. I'm doing another custom because that Bape Vans joint I did got like over 1,000 views. And like y'all was steadily watching that joint, like, I don't know, like y'all love that Bape custom. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna hit him with another custom. Then I'm gonna hit him with another custom after that custom. So this is the custom after the custom. But I made it the first custom because I won't wear these jumps. So yeah, today we got, I meant to say, welcome to another episode of Finesse Kicks like shit. But today we got Nike Box. Y'all can see I'm doing a Jordan custom. Jordan 1 custom. So I'm going to tell y'all, I'm going to show y'all how to turn these. They come out the damn box. Shit. Shout out to GOAT. Shout out to GOAT for supplying the custom. But I'm going to show y'all how to turn these yin yang, whatever they call, whatever the black one called, yin yang ones, the all black Jones. I wish I had the white Jones because it would have been a lot easier, but how to turn these into these. Hopefully y'all not getting blasted. I should have some B-roll for y'all. But how to turn those into these. I don't really have a name for them. As I look at my Bruce Lee poster, my painting I did. Except maybe like the Bruce Lee ones, like these was inspired by pretty much the Mamba Mentality Kyrie Jones, all the Bruce Lees Kobe did, like, and then that was inspired by the Fragments too. So you got like a Fragment mixed with like a Lightning 4 mixed with like the Mamba Mentality Kyrie 3s. I know that's a lot of shoes to be inspired by, but I think this joint fire. It came out dope. So I'm gonna just go ahead, get to the custom. Hopefully y'all enjoy it. Like I said, thumbs up, like, subscribe to the channel if you're new. And yeah, man. Oh yeah, one thing I gotta say. Please get the white jumps. If you gonna do this, and you don't care about the bottom being black, please get the white ones. The white yin yang, whatever they call. Get the white ones. Cause this black, it's hard as hell to paint it. You gonna see, you know what? Just get to the custom and get. Yeah, do that. What's good, YouTube? This your boy Jay Diggy. I know I already did the intro, so I'm not gonna do it again. But nah, excuse the way I look too. Well, y'all know what I'm about to do. Shit, how the fuck I'm explaining? But yeah, as you can see, we got Master Bruce in the background and shit. Excuse the bed, that shit fucked up. But that's who this custom is inspired by. And I'm gonna just give y'all the list of shit y'all need before y'all pretty much do this custom. All right, so I'm gonna flip the camera around. Here we go. All right, so what you gonna need? I say like a rag towel, whatever you wanna wipe your paintbrushes on. Definitely need a heat gun and tape. Tape not so much if you know what you're doing. Of course you need the shoes that you're working on. This is just a cup of water. You need nail polish remover, acetone, whatever you wanna call it. Of course your list of colors. I'm just using regular yellow. It don't really matter to me. Just whatever yellow. Damn, excuse me. You want your shoes to be definitely cotton balls and some good paint brushes, just so you ain't messing up like the brush strokes and it ain't like the paint ain't just going every which way and shit. So I'm gonna go ahead and get into this custom. Y'all gonna see the full process, and I'm gonna see y'all. I don't even know if I'm gonna see y'all. I'll see y'all in the next vid. If not, like, subscribe, comment, all that shit. Share with your homies. Join the God Squad. And yeah, man, I'm gonna stop talking, get up out of here so I can get this custom out the way. Love y'all.
All right, y'all. So first thing you're gonna wanna do is prep your shoe. When I say prep, I mean like tape it off and use acetone on it to rub off that old finisher. Oh yeah, side note, shout out Big Crit as I try to get these lights together. I know y'all can see that. If y'all haven't listened to the album, y'all playing y'allself. But yeah, man, taping it off is one of the most important steps in a good custom, just cause you want clean lines and you don't want the paint hitting certain areas of the shoe, and then you're gonna have a hard time either getting the paint off or repainting over it. So let's go ahead and get into this custom. I know I'm ashy as hell, this is a side note, so just don't play too much attention to that and just pay attention to the custom. Alright y'all, so I'm gonna speed this joint up and I'm gonna get y'all up out of here. She come, apprenticed in the temple with the Guangzhou Nim. I went through torture, deadly styles, I'm the author. Ingested metal, yeah, they make me supernova. Triple spinning kicks, side kicks, and hook kicks. Hey, come a chiller, so you must be master killer. Inside fool, change my style, change the weather. Inside fool, change your mind, just too clever. Inside fool, all the weak styles I sever. Combining 2 styles on the mic with master killer. Inside fool, change my style, change the weather. Inside fool, change your mind, just too clever. It's not fool, all the weak styles I sever. Combining 2 styles on the mic with master killer. The great ones have searched for the righteous data to show improve and master the seven. Still in the preparation phase. Almost messed this joint up. Almost put paint on it without prepping the shoe properly first. So as you can see, you got your cotton balls. You're going to take your nail polish remover and pretty much rub it all over the shoe in the areas that you want to paint over. Just so the paint will stick better and it adhere better. And you don't have to worry about paint falling off and chipping while you're walking down the mall with your girl. And now you look stupid because now your custom looks like trash because you didn't prep your shoe properly. Major key, always do this. And yeah, nail polish remover works fine. Acetone, even leather prepared deglazer from Angela. So let me shut up and get back to this dude prepping this. Dreams put a hole like operator standing by. What you grab with your heart or your weapon? The question. What you strap with a Glock or a message in a rhyme? A teacher can use as a part of a lesson. The choice between being a gangster and an artist is the start of your ending. You confront like you a gangster artist, but that ain't the smartest decision. Niggas will test you. They say you ain't the hardest, regardless of what you spare, homie. Risen told me that the game is flipping. Alright, so now that your shoe is prepped, now you can put the white paint on it or your base coat, whatever that is. You want to make sure that your base coat is extremely effective. For me, putting white on this black was hard as hell to do, but it had to be done. I used like 7-8 coats just to make it turn white. You need that, so if any lighter colors you're putting on the shoe, it shows through and it doesn't have like splotchy spots to where it's darker in some areas and lighter in others. So you definitely want to make sure your base coat is applied well and even. Not too worried about brush strokes right here because it's just a base coat, but definitely make sure you do it. That's why I said the white yin yangs would have been better, just because they're white and I could have just painted the primary colors that I wanted to use on the shoe. But you definitely want to take the time to do this step right, and it'll definitely make your custom stand out besides those that just put paint directly on a black shoe, which is crazy to me because it definitely would look like ass, but it's neither here nor there. So definitely you want to use this white and do as many coats as possible, hitting the heat gun in between those.
Sometimes we gotta flash and back. See, niggas know where this shit started, y'all know where it came from. I'm saying, we're gonna take y'all back to the source, the knowledge. Yeah,
when the MCs came to live out the name and to perform, some had to smoke cocaine to act the same. Swing swords and cut clowns. Shit is too swift to bite your recording.
the blood on a murder scene. Like a syringe or some wild out shit to insert a fiend. But it was your walk, the shop stolen art. Catch a swollen heart from not rolling smart. I put mad pressure on pony whack rhymes to get hurt. Sits plate like zodiac signs, a sweatshirt. That's minimum and feminine like sandals. My minimum table stacks the first on a gamble. Energy is felt once the cards are dealt. With the impact of roundhouse kicks from black belts that attack. And white bones like cyclones or typhoons. I represent from midnight to high noon. I don't waste ink, nigga. I think I drop megaton.
Alright, so 7 to 8 to 9 coats later, your shoe looks pretty much white. If it wasn't for this heat gun, this process would have been hella longer, but you definitely want to use a heat gun. That's your best friend when doing a custom, along with dope good brushes. So yeah, right here we're gonna go ahead and start applying this yellow paint. I'm not too worried about if it gets on to some of the parts of the shoe because I'm gonna black that out, but it's for white parts of the shoe. You want to definitely be careful because now you're gonna have to paint over the yellow with white, and then it's just more time consuming and you really don't want to do this. So just be careful on if you're painting it black. Don't really worry about it because the black's gonna overshadow it, but definitely be careful with the yellow and how you use it. And I'm gonna go ahead speed this up. I don't know what the hell this nigga's doing, but I'm gonna go ahead speed this up so I can get y'all up out of here. And yeah, just make sure that your yellow is really crisp and even all over the shoe. You don't want missing spots and dark spots in your custom, so it'll definitely help your custom out if you take your time and really pay attention to it.
Only been a good nigga for a minute though, cause I got to get my props and win it. Yo, I got beef with commercial ass niggas with gold teeth, camping in a Lexus seat and beat straight up and down, don't even bother. I got 40 niggas up in here now who kill niggas for me.
My people's, are you with me where you at? In the front, in the back, killer bees on the tap. My people's, are you with me where you at? Smoking meth, hitting cats on the block with the gap.
Here I go, deep type flow. Jack, you stole, can never get this. No, I'm Terry Bomb and shit. Boom, that's warming up a little bit. Rapping in is what's happening. Keep the pockets stacking in, hands clapping in at the party when I move my body. Gotta get up and be somebody. Grab the microphone, put strength to the bone. Dan, 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 into the Wu-Tang zone. Showing up when I rock that stuff up, pop. I'm gonna catch your bluff, tough, rough. Kicking rhymes like Jim Kelly or Alex Kelly. I'm a beat the belly rhymes. Coming raw style, hardcore. Niggas be coming to the hip-hop store. Coming to buy grocery from me. Turn out to be a hip-hop MC. The law, in order to enter the Wu-Tang, you must bring the old dirty bastard type slang. Represent the Jizza, Abbott, Ruzza, Shaquan. Inspect the deck, dirty hole getting low with his flow. Introduced in the ghost face killer. My people's, are you with me where you at? In the front, in the back, killer bees on attack. My people's, are you with me where you at? Smoking meth, hitting cats on the block with the gap.
Speaking of the devil's sight, know it's the guard, get your shit right. Mega trife, and yo, I killed you in a past life. On the mic while you was kicking that fast shit. You and Nick tried to get it, got blasted. Half-mastered ass style, mad rough jazz. When I struck, I had on Tim's in the black mask. Remember that shit? I know you don't remember Jack. That night, yo, I was sitting like a spike bat. And then you thought I was bugged out and crazy. Strapped for nonsense, after me became lazy. Yo, nobody budged while I shot slugs. Never shot ducks, I'm running with ducks that flood mugs. So grab your 8+1, start flipping. And tripping, niggas is jetting, I'm licking off, son.
Alright, so now we got our coats down. I use like 3 or 4 coats for this. Always, if you think your shoe is good, put one more coat on it. That's the motto I use. So, as you can see, we still got some blacks, some yellow covering the black spots, and that's fine because when we use this black, this is pretty much the finishing touch on the custom. Yeah, flat black. Thanks for showing that, J Diggy, because I definitely forgot. But yeah, I use flat black, but please be careful. You want to use the smallest brush possible to fill in the thicker areas, and everywhere else just use a detail brush. I know it might be time consuming and really take a like long time, but you definitely don't want to put black on a white surface or a light surface because it's going to be pale trying to get that up or trying to paint over it. So yeah, you definitely want to be careful with this. and use like the smallest brush possible that you have, unless you have your shoe taped up real good. Other than that, this is pretty much the end of it. Besides putting on a finisher, you go back in detail with the flat black if you need to, and hit the spots that may have got some little white or yellow over it. But other than that, this is pretty much the finishing touches. And only put like one to two coats of flat black just because it's black and I really didn't need that much. I ain't with this shoe looking all chunky and shit. But yeah, so flat black, definitely use a small brush and just take your time to make your custom look make your custom look like a dope fucking custom and not some trash ass I just begun YouTube ass custom. So I'm gonna go ahead, let him paint. We're gonna speed up this process a little bit, and I'm gonna see y'all when we get to the finishing process.
Wolves in the back, ready to protect. Soldiers in the front, let the heat on. Troops on the left, fighting to the death. Fam on the right, infrared lights. Wolves in the back, ready to protect.
Leather jackets on, rock the rock stars. Treacherous bank robbers, the plan. Yo, we pop guards. The team gotta eat seeds, it's hungry. That's why we ain't scared to dump on niggas. Our guns is chunky. Usually we bust niggas down with bats. Swell up they joints, elbow, shins get cracked. We still humiliate, brutalize, Ruger pop, polarize. Still got gear in the closet. Stupid life from Benetton, rugby skellies. Eyes cast, conduct the jumpers, the train fit me lucky. Rain job is the make the coat, coke is fluffy. While I politic is the bad bass with puppy. Back knee as soon as I link up, the kid ain't inked up. Old mommy, my go away as much as King Tech slippers, rose is linked up. I do durag, bro, my three dimensional fate is clean cut.
Niggas ain't shit to us. Fill a bitch through butch. Blit your melon, blip the Dutch. Got a lot of piff to puff. And I ain't come for piff the cuff. I'm for the cop that click the cuffs. Man, it's that and this bitch or what? The twisted weed. Twisted it up and mixed with dust. See, these fans can't resist the rush. They Wu-Tang for life. Scar for life, they can't forget the cuts. Got a whole line of classic joint. And while you at it, pass the joint. Let's put this past the point.
Alright, y'all. So we pretty much got this whole shoe finished. That joint looking nice, it's looking clean, these lines is looking dope. So I removed the tape already, y'all ain't need to see all that, but I had just to go back and fix some areas, just lay down some more white. But as for matte finisher, you can use matte finisher or high gloss. I chose matte just because I ain't want my shoes shiny as hell and they look fake and plastic or whatever. But when matte finisher, when you're applying it, you definitely want to use a good brush that is not really being used. And I say this because you don't want particles all over your shoe when you're applying the matte finisher. And now you got hair and other shit sealed in with the shoe. And now it can't come off even if you clean it. So you definitely want to use a good brush. That's why you'll see me switch, because it kind of almost messed up the paint a little bit when I was applying this finisher. So definitely use a soft brush. And then in between painting certain areas, I use the heat gun, as you see right here. Definitely just so it'll help this finisher hold in and stay in, and it won't gather as many dust particles once you dry it on. So it doesn't leave like that sticky matte finish. That's why you see me keep touching it, the shoe, throughout the applying of it, just because I don't want that sticky finish and have my custom feeling all gross and shit. It'll look dope, but then when you get up close and personal, it got bubbles and damn pizza crumbs and cookie crumbs. Like, you done took your custom to a whole new level. Like, I almost fucked up and put acetone on the shoe. I'm just glad I caught that shit. That's why I opened the bottle. That was really a fuck up that I just left and said fuck it, because I'm a real nigga. But yeah, just pour some into the cap like I'm doing right here, and get to work. Hit the heat gun in between as soon as you can, just to make that shit set in real good and don't leave it open to dust particles. And yeah, we're pretty much finished his custom. I'm going to let him do his thing. But go ahead, like, subscribe, comment. Like the video if you haven't already. Subscribe, become a part of the God Squad. You know how we do it. Finesse God with a finesse game strong. You can't go wrong. And yeah, man, I love y'all. Y'all want to follow me, anything, y'all know me. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, all that. JDiggy92. Shout out to our page, Finesse God Masterpieces. And Love y'all. Thanks for watching. And I'll see y'all when I see y'all.
The old dirty bastard is dirty and stinking. Ace on your knee rolling. With the knife of the creeps, the knee be rolling. With a stash, ain't saying gas. Bite my style, I bite your motherfucker.
Say it out loud, my style is wild, so book me. Not long is how long that this rhyme took me. Ejecting styles from my lethal weapon. My pen that rocks from here to Oregon. Here's more again. Catch it like a psycho flashback. I love gats. Rap was a gun. You wouldn't bust back. I'm going shit all types of shapes and sounds. And where I lounge, my stomping grounds. I give an order to my peeps across the water to go and snatch up props all around the border and get far like a shooting star. Pursue our all is living the life of Pablo Escobar. Point blank as I kick the square biz. There it is, the fuck pros and it goes.
Yo, chill with the feedback block. We don't need that. It's 10 o'clock, ho. Where the fuck you see that? Feeling mad hostile, ran out apostle. Throwing like Christ when I speaks the gospel. Stole with the holy robe, then attack the globe with the buckets. Style the ruckus. 10 times.
I tell you I'm good, probably you will say I'm boasting. But if I tell you I'm no good, you know I'm lying.
Word on the street, I got no bricks.
Well done, well done, well done.
Word on the street, I got gold bricks. Put King gold chains on yo bitch. Let her cry for me, that's Hootie and the Blowfish. She gon' blow dick, tootsie pop, how many licks? Blow this popsicle stand quick. Insane nigga getting bent in a Bentley. Hot head trigger nigga, don't tempt me. Make that ass shake.